start with the subject policy, heating, ventilation and air conditioning. Now in this particular subject, we are going to study all about the air conditioning system, how the heating and ventilation is done in a room or in an office or in any kind of application. So before going further into the detailed analysis of the subject, let us try to find out what is the basic principle behind the refrigeration system, and it's nothing but the reverse Carnot cycle. Now to understand the reverse Carnot cycle better, what we will do is, we will first go through the concept of the Carnot cycle in detail first, so that we can correlate with the existing systems. So the Carnot cycle consists of four reversible processes. Reversible because it gives the maximum efficiency in terms of the output, because of absence of any kind of irreversibilities present. So what are these four reversible processes? There are two reversible adiabatic processes and two reversible isothermal processes. So this particular cycle I am going to explain you with a piston and cylinder arrangement. So four different diagrams are given indicating four different processes. Process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. Now process 1 to 2 is carried out at a constant temperature, where heat is given keeping the temperature constant. So only the side walls of the cylinders are kept insulated, well insulated, so that no heat exchange takes place from the side walls from the system into the surrounding. So heat is given, simultaneously expansion will be taking place. Due to this expansion, pressure will be dropping to a certain level and volume is increasing. So this process is indicated on the PV graph. Suppose this is the initial pressure and volume condition indicated by P1 and V1. So as I said, there will be certain fall in the pressure with increase in volume. Okay, so we reach the state 2. Now after the piston reaches the position 2, the head of the cylinder is now insulated, so there is no possibility of any heat exchange between the system and the surrounding. So whatever heat is there, suppose these are the particles or the fluids, the heat exchange will be taking place from, or heat flow will be converted into work done, thereby resulting in the heat at higher temperature to heat at lower temperature. So during this process, as the movement of the piston occurs from 2 to 3, heat is being continuously converted into work. So lots of pressure will be dropping down. So this process 2 to 3, as you can see over here, the pressure is dropping to a great extent with a slight increase in the volume. Then process 3 to 4, this insulation is removed, heat is being extracted out of the system when the piston is moving from 3 to 4. So due to this, what will happen? There will be again smaller rise in the pressure because the heat is continuously removed, so this heat is not responsible for much rise in the pressure. But due to the movement of the piston, there will be considerable change in the volume. So this is process 3 to 4 on the PV graph. Then 4 to 1, again we insulate the system completely, that is we insulate the head of the cylinder. So in this zone, whatever heat is being accumulated, due to that, there will be random heat exchange or energy exchange process between the molecules of the fluid, and this random heat exchange or energy exchange process between the fluid will give rise to a much rising pressure, but there is slight change in the volume. So this is represented by this particular process 4 to 1. So process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 are reversible isothermal process, and process 2 to 3 and 4 to 1 are reversible adiabatic process. Now let us try to construct this PV graph on the TS graph or TS curve. So process 1 to 2 is happening at a constant temperature, but heat is being added. This addition of heat will give rise to addition or increase in entropy. Why? Because dS equal to dQ by T. So any change in the heat parameter will give the increase in the entropy as well. As the temperature is constant, it's a horizontal line, so you will get process 1 to 2 in this fashion. Now process 2 to 3 is nothing but insulation is taking place, it becomes a reversible adiabatic process. That means nothing but it's an isentropic process. So isentropic process means entropy will be remaining constant. Now as the heat is changing from heat at a higher temperature to heat at a lower temperature, temperature is dropping down. So you can see this process is dropping down in the temperature. 3 to 4 again, we are exchanging the heat at a constant temperature, again it's a horizontal line. But as the system is losing the heat, the entropy of the system will be reducing. Therefore you can see process 3 to 4 as reduction in entropy process with constant temperature. And 4 to 1 again reversible adiabatic process, that means isentropic process. So 4 to 1 will remain constant in terms of entropy, but temperature will be increasing due to high increase in pressure. So in a closed system we always encounter pressure and temperature are directly proportional to each other. So in this way we have found out the net work done on the graph and net heat exchange on the graph with respect to TS graph over here. So now let us try to find out how is exactly this is giving the maximum efficiency. So process 1 to 2, as we apply the first law of thermodynamics to this system, we always get heat equal to change in internal energy plus work done. So heat is supplied at a higher temperature, QH equal to U2 minus U1, that's final internal energy minus initial internal energy, plus work done during that process 1 to 2. As the piston is expanding, the work is done by the system is positive. Process 2 to 3, there is no heat exchange, it's a reversible adiabatic process. So we get U3 minus U2 plus W2 to 3. Again expansion is taking place, it's a positive work. Process 3 to 4, what are we doing is we are extracting the heat from the system into the surrounding at a constant temperature. So it will be heat at lower temperature equal to final internal energy U4 minus initial internal energy U3 minus W3 to 4. As compression is taking place, it's a negative work. 4 to 1 process will give 0 heat exchange being an isentropic or reversible adiabatic process. U1 minus U4 change in internal energy minus W4 to 1. Okay, so these are the heat first law of thermodynamics applied to the system for Carnot cycle. Now let us try to add all these. What we will get on the left side, QH plus 0, QH plus 0. Now this will be minus or plus, that is the question to be asked. So what is done over here, heat is thrown out from the system to the surrounding. So whenever heat is being extracted from the system, it becomes negative. So here we will get QL equal to U2 minus U2 cancel, U1 minus U1 will get cancelled, minus U1 and U1, U3 minus U3 will get cancelled, and U4 minus U4 will get cancelled. So if you sum up all the change in the internal energy, what you get is in the end there is no change of the internal energy. That's what we go with the, that's why we go with the reversible processes. So you will get 0 in terms of the internal energy change, and in terms of work done, what we will get is W1 to 2 plus W2 to 3 minus W3 to 4 plus W4 to 1. So this is nothing but summation of all the work done. and this is nothing but summation of the heat. So as there is no change in the internal energy, all the heat supplied is converted to work done, and therefore we get the maximum thermal efficiency. So I think we are clear the concept of the Carnot cycle, and then in our next lecture or in our next video we will go with the reverse Carnot cycle. Thank you.